What about if, just for once, the luxury sector lined up with the aspirations of our society? In Lomé, Togo, a gang of friends is preparing for a road trip. Getting to the village of Ilou, to the west of Kara, in the north of the country, is a seven-hour journey. The minibus's passengers, two models and influencers, two photographers, and a young executive who's a specialist in eco-friendly lipstick. It's a simple idea. For every lipstick sold, he'll donate 100 litres of drinking water.
I'd had this idea in my head for quite a long time. And at the same time, we started seeing this whole wave of social change, climate change, a change when it comes to the impact of waste. And so that was when I thought that, in the end, a brand has to be aware of its era, its time, and not just its product. That's what I tried to do with Bouche Rouge, unite luxury, pleasure, sensuality, and eco-responsibility.
A symbol of seduction, lipstick's also a money spinner for manufacturers, but making the product uses up large amounts of water and plastics. So Nicolas Gerlier decided to move away from pushing something that increases pollution, and with help from artistic director Ezra Petronio, he developed a line of cosmetics that respects the environment.
Being able to innovate was a fundamental part of what we wanted to do. If you want to innovate and you're not running your own lab, your own research body, you are reliant upon the errors of others. You're dependent on other people's research. And since we wanted to take a radically different approach, no one was able to do that except us.
The business puts French know-how and excellence in craftsmanship front and center. The interior mechanisms, plastic-free and made in Brittany. The leather comes from tanneries in the Alsace and Auvergne regions, and the stick itself was made in Cosmetic Valley in Chartres. The lipstick's rechargeable because 1 billion lipstick casings are thrown away every year. La Bouche Rouge doesn't finance the drilling or digging of wells directly. Instead, it donates to a series of projects piloted by the Eau Vive Internationale NGO, initiatives which manage water resources and establish purification plants.
Well, it was a real surprise, because we did wonder, what can the industry, I mean, what can a lipstick do in terms of development? But then we understood that it was really very interesting. It was a good idea to bring together the economic aspect and the social aspect.
Before Eau Vive Internationale started working in the village, infant mortality was close to 25%. The root cause, poor hygiene. Togo welcomes foreign investors when it comes to financial assistance. The construction of toilet facilities is key, as well as education to promote good habits like washing your hands. Children are quick to pick up on visual cues, and staging an open-air show is a fun way to get that message across. Here, the actors and actresses are local people, and the story shows the family using water from the drilled well thrive, while the one without access to basic hygiene falls seriously ill.
It was really important for me to come here because when you work in fashion and you see what's going on beneath the surface, you realize very quickly that something has to be done. The amount of waste. I think it's really important to talk about it and to show what they've done, show what's been achieved here, especially because this is the reality. It's not just about donating money. These are lives that have been improved. And when you have a certain level of visibility, a certain amount of influence, I think you also have a certain amount of responsibility too. I don't just want to say, buy this, buy that. I want to spread a positive message.
Louise and Mélodie are models and influencers. They've each developed a signature shade of lipstick and are voluntary brand ambassadors.
Nicolas offered me a commission, a percentage of the profits for this shade, and I told him I'd rather that commission went to Eau Vive Internationale. Because I work enough during the year to be able to give up some of my time for free.
donner de mon temps gratuitement.
And it's about gradually being aware of what's going on in the world and doing something useful, that's all.
One way of being useful, getting the message out there.
The new economies that we see today are lucky to be able to do something meaningful. I'm calling on all the startups, the ones doing well, to get involved, to share a little of their economic success, pass on a little of their growth to a project that counts, a project that has a direct impact on people who have nothing.
Traditional wells made digging some 15 meters into the ground can't be used during the dry season and are easily contaminated. Drilling down to 90 meters means the water's clean and safer to drink, an objective supported by the projects which make this dream a reality.
I'm Narissa Bricas, and you'll usually find me in news, reporting on Greece's enduring financial turmoil and protests, but also the refugee emergency, here on France 24.
Natalie Savarikas, one of the 200 France 24 correspondents around the world.